Is he here already?
Yes, he's inside, boss.
All right, okay.
Yeah, we're on.
How are you, son?
Isabel?
Francis?
Glad you can make it on such short notice.
It's no problem at all. I see you brought fresh meat.
This is my son, Jimmy.
Are you sure he's yours?
This is Jake.
Nice to meet you.
All right then, lads. Milady. I see you're getting younger, Francis.
Why have you come alone?
Where's Randy?
Dad can't make it. Didn't he tell you?
No, he didn't. I guess it must have slipped his mind.
Yeah, I guess so. Got the call earlier. Said he's got to lay low for a while. Gone Milan for a few days.
Good for him.
Hey, Jimbo, how you doing?
Don't call me that.
Oh, I am sorry.
Max, let me introduce you to my godson, Jake.
Heard a lot about you, mate.
It's all true. Tell me, Francis, did you brew this? It tastes like fucking piss. I thought this was a dick's only party. Where'd the pussy come from? I get it. It's going to be a night period talk. It's fine.
I'm more of a man than you'll ever be. Just pass me a strap on. I'll show you.
I might just like that.
So we came here to make some serious money.
Yeah, all right. Here.
What the fuck is this?
He's bigger than my ex-husband.
What happened to him?
Who?
Your ex-husband.
Oh, you don't want to know.
Now go on, surprise us all.
I sliced his dick off and watched it bleed out.
Touché.
Oh, Francis, these cuds are all sticky.
I'll definitely take one of those.
No. I remember my first time.
Oh yeah, I couldn't get it up.
No, you gobshite. My first smoke. I was 7 years old.
Well, I blame your parents.
So do I. My dad was a wrong and all right.
Oh, here comes the sob story.
Oi, show some respect.
No drama, son.
Chill out, Jimbo. Your man knows that we're having a laugh.
You remind me more and more of your dad every day.
You two go back a long way, don't you?
40-odd years now.
Went to school, yeah?
Is that what he told you?
He doesn't talk about his past much, to be honest.
I don't blame him.
You can talk about it.
It's not my place, son.
Oh, come on, Francis. It's not like he's here, is it?
It was 1974 when I first met your old fella. I remember it like it was yesterday. I was in my late teens. He was a bit younger than me. We were just kids, really. wet behind the ears, innocent to most of the shite going on in the world. My dad said to me, it's time to join the family business. Become a man, he says. So that night, he took me down to docks for a last minute job. It was freeze your bollocks off cold. To this day, I still remember the sting of that rain. Anyway, there was your granddad Ernie, and behind him was your Elfella. I think Ernie had the same idea as me dad did. See, they had some fella tied up. He'd been there a couple of days. I don't remember his name, but I remember his face. It was thin, bloody, wet with tears. Scared shitless, you know the crack. They said that he was a snake and we were to show no mercy. Ernie took out his gun and gave it to your dad. Told him to put the poor bastard out of his misery. My dad gave me his. Told me not to think of it as a life to be ended, but as a loose end to be cut. I knew it was his first time too, because his hands were shaking as bad as mine. This bloke's screams just got louder and louder. So loud, I almost couldn't hear myself think.
My dad told me he went first. Said you couldn't handle it.
That wasn't a very nice thing to say, was it?
How about you share something with us then?
I think the lady should go next.
Okay. I'll keep it short and sweet. I killed my father. He was touching me and my little sister up. And then I went for my mother. She knew what was happening, but she turned a blind eye to it all. So I ripped out her eyes, and now she no longer needs to pretend that she can't see.
Well, this is getting interesting.
Your turn.
What about you?
I'll save the best till last. I promise it'll be worth it.
Fair enough. Right, my first kill.
Favourite.
You what?
Your favourite kill. The one you enjoyed the most.
Well, there have been quite a few. The one that really springs to mind was around 10 years ago. Just after I joined the family business. A dear friend of mine, her old boss, was giving her a hard time. Making her work longer hours for less pay, that kind of thing. So I decided to pay him a visit. Told him to cool it down a little. You know, give him a chance. But he didn't take it. So a week later, I decided to pay him another visit.
So what did you do with it? The body?
Took him down to the canals. Tied one end of the rope to his ankles. And the other to the heaviest rock I could find. Pushed the bastard into the water. Watched him disappear into the night.
What?
Your turn, Silent Jake.
All right. You see, my father, he was a mechanic all his life. And I spent most of my childhood playing around with flat tires and broken exhaust pipes. But on my 16th birthday, he bought me a car. I was so excited. I didn't know how to drive it, you know, but he soon taught me. We'd race up and down the street for hours, bonding just like a father and son should. And this one day, we're at my dad's garage, doing some work to my new motor. And some guy comes out of nowhere demanding that the car is his. And that my father had just taken it from him. I saw the look in my father's eyes and I knew he was guilty. And that's when I realised what he really was. See, he wasn't just a mechanic. He was a crook.
Just hold on a minute. I thought we were sharing best kills. sharing best birthday stories.
Let him finish, boy.
I still remember the guy now, you know. I just stood there shouting in my father's face. My father, not even batting an eyelid, not even once. Instead, he just turns to me and asks one simple question. Do you want this car or not? I nodded, and that's all it took. Before I knew it, my father grabs this guy by the collars and he's dragging him inside. He orders me to close the shutters, and I do exactly what he says. And then my father just begins to punch this man, you know. Kicks him really hard in the face. I've never seen anything like it. Blood everywhere. All over his face, his clothes, his hands. And then everything just stops. And my father looks at me. And I know what's coming, I know what he wants, but I just freeze. And then he picks up these pliers. And he makes his way over. He takes my hand. And he places those pliers inside. And you know something? It felt good.
It's the life they chose for us. We didn't have a choice.
Right then, ladies. See if I can beat all your, shall I call them, fascinating tales. So around about 4 months ago, my father got word of some prick running his mouth about our business. He'd witnessed my dad carving up some brute. I was gonna give evidence against him. Didn't take dad long to track him down. Nick his name was. Anyway, dad got me to pay young Nicholas a visit. Thing is, he wasn't in. No. But his wife was. All nice and warm. Tucked up in bed! Jimbo, you should have smelled her. She smelled so good. Better than that fucking whiskey anyway. I thought to myself, it was a long drive back. So I decided to make myself comfortable. I got into bed. Her smell, so fresh, like roses. I stroked her smooth hair, smooth skin all the way downstairs, shaved just the way I like it. She turned to face me. She looked so posh, a posh bitch. It took her a few seconds to realize it was me. She screamed, I pulled out my gun, BANG! Whoa! Blood splattered all over the walls. It was beautiful. Almost poetic. No more warmth. No more screaming. I was really starting to enjoy myself as well. All up until I found another treat for me. A little girl. Screaming. Just like her mother.
Looks like I'm not the only pussy in this room after all.
Told you we'd get him.
That piece of shit is all yours now, Nick.
Nick. You fucking cunt.
Her name was Lily. She would have been one today.
Take more than a handkerchief, son.
It's been good.
Has it?
Just let it out, son. That's it. Just let it out.
You sure you want this? We could run the city.
Not with that son of a bitch cartel running about the place.
Won't be long till he starts asking questions about Max. Look after yourself.
You know where we are.
Just my way of saying thanks.
Randy fucking Cartel.